It's a vlog.
Now this is making me want to get the game a bit more, plus I would like to pick up Killzone 3 anyways. Hi, and Steam Rook and CC Films, it's a vlog. Now, as you may know, like I said in many of times, I'm saving up for a 3DS. It's not saying I can save up for the 3DS and get two particular games at the same time. It's just, I was planning to get like a certain amount of money to be able to buy them two games and still carry on saving up for the 3DS. It's not saying that I can trade in a particular thing to be able to get them two particular games, even though that sum of money that I was waiting for didn't even come. And it's just that, yeah, because I'm having problems on trying to get them two games while maintaining on saving up for 3DS. But now, I just want to quickly say that I'm not supposed to allow to talk these sort of things, you see. It's not saying I'm allowed to talk these things, because just recently a particular person said that I'm not allowed to talk these various things on the internet and all that. Thanks, internet. Now, it's not saying I would like to talk about it, it's just those people online are like getting a bit jealous, and also it's trying to maintain those people that are jealous and also things that I'm not supposed to talk about on the internet. But there has been kind of rumours going about that basically the benefit claims are going a bit, you know, charging a bit more and stuff like that, which I heard. I don't think it will happen, but I'm not so sure, because my mum does all these sort of things and manages my money. But yeah, what can you do? But I won't discuss about it anymore, because like I said, a particular person said that I'm not supposed to talk about it anyways. But hopefully maybe when I go to see my mum this weekend, this Sunday coming, which is tomorrow, maybe if I ask my mum really nicely, because I don't ask for things on my account, because I save things on my own, and maybe if I ask my mum really nicely, if I take some money on my account that I don't normally use, then I might get Bulletstorm and Killzone 3. Hopefully, fingers crossed though. But like I said, I'm not supposed to talk about these things, you see. Anyways, let's go discuss about topics. Minecraft. I recently started playing Minecraft, even though it's like a baby version, like Lego block sort of thing. It's the free version I'm talking about, not the full version. I can understand why people like playing Minecraft, the full version and all that. And I gotta say, it's quite good. It's not saying I will pick it up myself. It's just that sometimes I don't buy stuff online, because I had to ask my mum, because she's the owner of my money, you see. So, it's not to say I'll buy Minecraft. I would like to buy Minecraft, but it's quite funny, because me and my friend Adam Rose, because Adam Rose was convincing me, the legendary Adam Rose, convincing me to play Minecraft, and if I kind of play Minecraft and get into it, he said it will try and buy me it. But the problem is, though, it's funny, though, because me and Adam, we have money issues at the moment, because we're both saving up for 3DS and all that. And it's funny, though, because Adam has kind of this thing where he gives me like stuff for no apparent reason. I do return him back, which I'll explain in a minute, because I do return stuff him back in favour, and it's kind of what online friends do. Anyways, enough about that. Another topic that I want to discuss about is, this is why I'm wearing this t-shirt today, which is the Back to the Future t-shirt, because I've just been playing the Back to the Future game. Now, it is exclusive for PlayStation Network, iPad, and PC. Now, however, because I have an American account on PlayStation Network, I kind of tried out the demo for the PlayStation Network version. Now, I gotta say, as a fan of Back to the Future, I kind of like it. Even though that I never played a Telltale's game, even though that the Telltale's games are meant to be like a point-and-click adventure, that sort of thing, because I never played Wallace and Gromit, or Sam and Max, those sort of Telltale's games, but for some reason, because I'm a fan of Back to the Future, I played it, and it's one of them games, like, basically, it takes half an hour to get used to, and once you play through it again, it takes about, like, 2 minutes, but I would like to pick it up, though. But the problem is, though, because I like playing on my Xbox 360 a lot, I would like it to pick up on Xbox 360, because it's PlayStation Network, iPad, and PC exclusive, it's not going to be available for Xbox Live Arcade, unless, because I watch Send You Messages on the dashboard, on the Xbox, if you watch certain shows on the dashboard, which is the send you a message episodes, that someone sent a message to send you a message saying that if there was any way to get Back to the Future on XBLA. There is a way, though, but it Telltale's, the company that makes the game, did say that they would put it on Xbox Live Arcade, but you kind of like have to like form a group or convince them, and Telltale's did say that they will, you know, put on XBLA if you ask them or put a group in or convince them really nicely to be able to get on XBLA. It's not saying I'll pick it up on PlayStation Network, it's just knowing me, I play on my Xbox a lot, I would like some of them achievables and stuff like that. But I gotta say, it's a brilliant game. If you haven't already played the Back to the Future demo on PlayStation Network, you might have to get on the you might have to import it because it's on the US service at the moment. But I gotta say, it's really good. It brings out loads of quirky quotes and other types of things from the films, and I like it. And I like it, as you can see, I'm a Back to the Future fan. Right, let's explain about some other things I found out on the internet. Now, after reading through Major Nelson's blog, basically, there will be some deals that are happening. There will be loads of Tom Clancy stuff on sale. I don't want to go through it because it's all just boring and stuff. But there was like Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory for 600 Microsoft points, some Avatar gear for 200 Microsoft points, and some DLCs for particular games. I would like to pick up the DLC for Splinter Cell Conviction Bomb. Not much, I haven't got much Microsoft points at the moment. But overall, yeah, they're doing that. But the major thing that I'm kind of really interested in to tell you guys, I only picked the good ones, you see, sorry to say. But if you look up on Major Nelson's blog, then basically you'll know these sort of things. And I don't have to explain it to you, and this is why I like to do these vlogs, just to explain to you. But there is basically Pac-Man Championship Edition DX. Now, that's up for 800 Microsoft points at the moment, but at February 28th on Deal of the Week, they'll be doing it for 400 Microsoft points. Now, I regret myself on getting that now, because recently I got free 800 Microsoft points for doing a certain thing on Xbox Live, and I got 800 free Microsoft points. But then when I got that, I really wanted to get the Pac-Man Championship Edition DX, and I got that straight away. And I was like, oh damn, I could have got it cheaper now. It's one of them things, like, you buy stuff, then you regret when you're buying it. But, yeah, in case any of you guys that are interested in Pac-Man Championship Edition DX, it's 400 Microsoft points, and it'll be a week only, starts at February 28th. But I do recommend it. I highly recommend that game than it is than the normal Championship Edition, because the DX Edition is slightly more better, slightly more fast-paced, because for some reason I kind of like playing that more than the normal Championship Edition. Just want to query on that. Another thing that's been happening on the internet is recently Left 4 Dead 2 is starting to do more DLC, which is cool, because I'm a fan of Left 4 Dead 2, because Left 4 Dead 2 is like my favourite first-person shooter slash horror type game, and they will be working on DLC. Now, the DLC is called Coldstream, if I pronounce that right, and they will be working on it after when Portal 2 is released, and I'm looking forward to that, because like I said, I'm a fan of Left 4 Dead 2 and stuff like that, and some Valve games and all that. But knowing the pricing, it'll be like $560 for Xbox, since I own it on Xbox, and be free for PC. That's what the usual prices are usually for them DLCs for Left 4 Dead 2. Anyways, speaking about survival and horror, yesterday night, after watching Hard News, I'm Destin, and this is Hard News. I like watching Hard News, that way I can keep up to things. But I didn't realise that this Dead Island trailer that was early on the internet, I haven't watched it until I watched Hard News. This is Hard News. When I watched that trailer, I was like, wow, this game is sick. That is Dead Island. I'm like, wow, this is actually a cool trailer. And when I watched that, and then there was some gameplay or something, I haven't watched the gameplay or whatever that was on the internet, but it seemed like a cool game. And I hope it goes well, because that trailer looks sick. You haven't seen the trailer, it's really cool. Adam Rose wants me to mention this, I don't know why, but I'll mention it anyways. For those guys that are interested in Infamous, there will be the Infamous 2 is coming out soon, and there will be a Hero Edition where you basically get Cole's sack bag thing, you know, they wears in the game. And also, I don't know why, for some reason, because Adam's a fan Sly Cooper. And for some reason, it's got Sly Cooper on the bag, and he's super, super pumped and all that. I do not know if it will be basically like Little Big Planet 2, where you had to import it and stuff. But we'll have to see how it comes and see if there'll be a Hero Edition here. But the Hero Edition looks really cool, in case any of you guys... I know most PS3 fans that watch my videos might be interested, but yeah, it looks really, really cool. And I just wanted to mention that because my friend Adam Rose is wanting me to mention that. Speaking about Adam Rose, let's discuss about videos. Now, because I've been remastering some videos, and Adam knows that I'm really good at my editing skills now, and basically, my friend Adam wants me to remaster one of our favourites. Well, actually, it's Adam's favourite, but I was Clyde into it, and that is the Burnout Paradise Big Island. I have forgotten the name. It's a long time since I played Burnout, because my friend Adam Rose is a big racing fan, you see, and I wanted to treat him for a birthday, but knowing me, I'm not really good when it comes to posting packaging, but he asked me for a birthday sort of gift. I would like to remaster that video, and because the audio was a bit dumb, because you couldn't hear Adam really well, and I was really dumb on how to use the Dazzle Capture Card, but I mastered it now, so I might remaster that. So in case a random video pops up of that, then blame Adam, because he wants a birthday present from me. Another thing I would like to mention is hopefully in ties with that, I might at some point I need to do my Xbox 360 collection. It's the biggest collection ever, because maybe some point, if I don't get the money for Bulletstorm or Killzone 3, then I might consider how to trade in most of my Xbox games, and then I'll do my Xbox 360 collection at some point. But anyways, it's not saying I would like to trade them in, it's just I would like to trade in some of the Guitar Heroes and also the Call of Duty collection I got, but I'd rather keep them. It's not saying I would get rid of them, because I despise Call of Duty, like I said many times. But I'd rather keep them, because most of my mates are like, Stevie, you don't have any decent games unless it's COD. That's my mates for years. But yeah, and another thing I want to mention is basically they're kind of cutting down on the RuneScape now, because their memberships for RuneScape are dying, and basically they've got nothing else better to do, so they're kind of not going on the RuneScape no more, which is good, so basically I can get on the internet a bit more. Just want to quickly mention on that. And other videos that I will work on. So anyways, do not forget to follow me on Facebook and Twitter, like I normally say, and also I'd like to thank any of you guys that are new to my channel and subscribed and all that, and thank you for watching to the end of this video. Don't know why I wanted to say that, but yeah, and thank you all you guys that are new and subscribed and all that. I will be working on some cool videos, and how I'm getting all these subscribers lately, but it's great though. At least for some reason, it's funny, because I'm getting not much people viewing, and I'm getting all these subscribers for no apparent reason. I never do the subs for sub, or convincing them, or paying them, or anything like that. I just do my videos, and most of my old videos are getting loads of publicity and all that, and I think that might be why I can kind of gain loads of subscribers. But anyway, stay tuned, I'll be doing loads of cool videos, and hopefully, fingers crossed, I would like to get Killzone 3 and Bulletstorm, so expect maybe an unboxing, maybe, fingers crossed, but we'll have to see. Anyways, I better go now. See you from CT Films.